My mother was my absolute best friend. She was my best friend. I've never found one better friend still. But I told my mother, I was going to say everything. I didn't tell her everything, but I told her most things. Like, I'll give you an example. Like, I always had girlfriends. And one time I came home and I says, Mom, Tony Mainini, that was who it was, Tony Mainini, says she put my hand in her panties. And you know, I remember my mother said, oh, really? Were they lacy panties? Were they cotton? My mother didn't get excited about that. You know, she just spoke to me like a peer and heard it. But I could tell my mother most things. Yeah, you know, I didn't tell her, you know, of course, I didn't tell her about my brother. But, yeah, so she was my best friend. It's kind of nice to have that. Mm-hmm. And I think I am, and I hope I am, turning into my mother. It's so amazing how, you know, other showgirls are afraid or nervous, and they get through it different ways. Like they look above the crowd, and there's tricks, or they're loaded on booze.
Do you ever do that?
No.
No.
And I look at people. I like connecting, and I think people like that very much. Okay. These tits belong to Kimberly Williams. She's one of our best pornographic actresses here in the city. And a mold was made of her bosoms. And my sister, Alana Persona, made a gift of them for me, to me. Okay, let's see if I can put it on with this bra. Looking for nuggets? You gold digger, or are you a gold digger? Well, here's a couple of nuggets. But you know, there's a whole bunch of stories, like I wanted a baby. I wanted his baby. And I have a sister who was going to carry the baby for us. Actually, you know, he was gonna fuck her, and then she was gonna give me the baby. How's that for a story? I says, no. Both of you might like it. Can't do that. No, we didn't do it. But that was during the time we were doing heroin, so it probably wouldn't have been good. But you know, I wanted to have a baby. I wanted to have children. I wanted his baby. And you know, since I'm talking about that, I should make this like a complete little story. A heartbreak for me was he told me that I wasn't his erotic ideal. And I said, Ted, you are mine. I says, you know, no other one exists but you. You know, you're all I want. And that, you know, that hurt me. He said that erotically that I wasn't, you know, he didn't say this, but like, you know, when we were doing it, he was picturing somebody else. He didn't tell me that, but so that was hard for me to hear. But he loved me, I know. And that's one time that I know I was truly, truly loved. We loved each other very, very much. And we were family. And he it was so important to him to be in my family. She was so happy. He's here. Now we're gonna have fun. Or something like that. I mean, she was always so happy to see me. And everything I did was just the most fabulous thing. And she wanted to hear every detail. You know? And like, if I made her a pickle jar, I painted a pickle jar, and that was her Mother's Day gift, she would never, it would always be there. You know, she was the most brilliant thing in the world. And you know, so I kind of, everything that I know came from her, I think. Because I, you know, I would like to believe, this is really vain, but I kind of turned into my mother.